Rodney Rascona is an advertising photographer who often uses his skills to raise awareness for humanitarian organizations around the world. His photographs manage to capture the strength, dignity, and resilience of people who struggle daily just to survive. Here to talk about his work is Rodney Rascona. He's a chief photographer for Food for the Hungry, a Phoenix-based Christian charity that seeks to end hunger and poverty worldwide. Welcome to Horizon. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you very much.
How long have you been doing this for Food for the Hungry? What exactly do you do for Food for the Hungry?
I became involved with FH about 2000. First project was going to Ethiopia for about 3 weeks to, at that time, try to identify if famine was in certain part of their fields where they were working. And I just stumbled into them just as a fluke. I had a small office across from the Scottsdale Air Park. And they came up on the web one day that there was an earthquake in Istanbul, and I had sent an email out saying, hi, you know, senior photographer, and if you need any photography, I have that. And lo and behold, they wrote me back, and we had a three-hour conversation a couple days later, and I thought that was it, and next thing I know, I had a phone call to go to East Africa for them.
Wow.
And that started a very, very long relationship, which has just been an unbelievable experience.
You write that you create portraits to convey messages of need. What does that mean? And what does that mean?
Well, you know, as you know, as a newsman, that there is a constant vying for the audience's attention on a myriad of issues. And one minute it's the Oscars, the next minute it's an earthquake in Chile and Japan, and there is a direct need for most of the organizations working around the world that are involved with the human condition to raise revenue. It's just the reality of the everyday life of making things happen. It costs money. And so I am a rare kind of unique set of experiences because I'm, as you said, I'm an advertising photographer for 30-some years. And I've been with Food for the Hungry and other NGOs for the last 13 years, about 12 or 13 years. And that traditionally requires me to go unaided to a particular field. Specifically, I work a lot in East Africa, mm-hmm. Rwanda, Uganda, Kenya, Ethiopia, many, many times over the years, dealing with issues, AIDS, HIV, education, food security, famine, unfortunately, sometimes. Drought. I've been dealing with drought since 2000. So creating images which are poignant. In our world, there is no shortage of disposable photographs. Mm-hmm. It's not until you try to create a serious body of work around serious subjects to help educate and to inform the viewer, the consumer. And that's the place for serious photographers.
And we're looking at some serious photographs here from East Africa, correct?
These were from Dadaab. This was just the first part of September. I was out there for a couple of weeks with Food for the Hungry.
And when we look at these photographs, when you look at these photographs, do you see that gentleman and this woman, were, when you saw them from a distance or askance, did you say, that's a face I need to capture? Or when you captured the face, did you say, my goodness, look at this work.
No, it's a lot more cerebral than that, and more happenstance. It's instinctual. I have come to accept I'm very, very good in working with the human condition. I'm very, very good at it. And I've really tried to figure out how that and why that is, but it's mostly probably to my own sense of humanity about these subjects. It's usually very, very hard for me to even get through talking about them without tearing up. Mm-hmm. It's there's a lot of pain and suffering in the world. So as a photographer, I try to, you know, there's photographers and then there's those of us who are senior photographers, a lot of experience, let's put it that way. That I look to myself to create something much more so than someone who maybe just came out of college with a camera. I believe that I should require myself to do much more than that. And so these images, I couldn't say they were planned, they weren't thought of in advance. It's me being put at the crossroads of something that's happening and then me applying a skill set. And it may be more technical than human, But most of the times when I'm in the field, I don't even use a camera the first couple of days. Yeah. I'm really making relationships.
I was going to say, making relationships has to be important here. Is it difficult? Is it difficult to have people trust you, woman carrying water, man carrying sticks, these sorts of... I mean, these people, they don't have time to fool around. And here you are, someone they're not familiar with. Is it difficult to get through to them, to get that connection, that relationship?
You know, I would say it is probably maybe for some. It's not for me. I seem to possess a certain amount of integrity that they feel. There's no shortage of people either in the camps in Dadaab or in Ethiopia or wherever it is. There's no shortage of government photographers or non-government photographers out there or news photographers. And I would like to say that most of their reasons for being there are true, but unfortunately that's not the case. My work is purely, like the work that I did in Dadaab, the work I did there was, I had probably 6 hours inside 3 days on the ground. Mm-hmm. It took a long time to get the permits. The UNHCR, who's governing the camps, have a very tight lid on it. It's an emergency environment. This particular kind of photograph, Asilo, that was only one, that was the first image of a concept that I wanted to do. It didn't get to go any beyond that because there was a major food distribution mm-hmm. right when we had planned that. So the other 20 women who planned to be there didn't show up, consequently. But when you are trying to work with the human condition, photography really doesn't mean a lot.
I want to get to some of your photographs from Haiti before we run out of time, because these are, look to me now, this is where an advertising photographer gets into that truth and the two mix, and you wind up with striking images here. Talk to us about, again, the cerebral method here, because these are obviously... These are photographs that you tried to get on a consistent basis with people in a kind of a consistent field. What's going on here?
Well, this is the Pink Door photographs, and I had just come back from, with Food for the Hungry, I just come back from Kenya in early January when the earthquake hit. And we immediately were going to go out to the field, and through some various NGOs, the Paradigm Project, Food for the Hungry, MedAir, these are all related organizations that know one another. And at the time, photography that was coming out was mostly journalistic in nature. So it was very dire photographs of truckloads of dead bodies and rubble, and it was very bleak. So I was challenged to go out and create images of hope. And because I'm not a photojournalist where I would respond to what I would see, I went out specifically with the idea to put elements, whether it be lighting, camera style, technique. I did everything contrary to what I would normally do. Mm-hmm. And that was the advertising side of me that sought a concept. What does that look like? Is it a body of work of, we originally were going to do a body of work on the aid workers coming in from France, but they had already left. So we, over the space of 5 nights, we invited people from the street, allowed them to get cleaned up, and come in front of this particular colorful background, which spoke to me from an advertising standpoint, and was also very anthropological. So the background wasn't of a concern. It was the people that you were focusing on, because the photograph was, the background was the same through all of them,
sure,
the body of work. But the goal was to raise a level of awareness to bump the visual aesthetics that would then give the message, the story, some longer airplay. Consequently, that work was awarded International Photographer of the Year, Deeper Perspective. We won that at the Lucy this time last year for that work. And what was really fascinating is that out of 100-some countries and some 12,000 entries, they selected I didn't get paid for it. It was a humanitarian job, and that won out. And so it means that imagery on a high order, serious imagery created by serious photographers on serious subjects, where photographers are allowed to be part of, spend time with their subjects, be in the field in a very classic way journalists have done for years, something happens. Something special comes from that. And the whole goal is you're trying to apply senior skill set to create something which will stand out. And so that's done well for that subject. Right now it's slated for spring to be an exhibition in London. trying to raise all the revenue for it. But it's what's required to, these kinds of projects are required to raise attention these days, to cut through the clutter of everybody's got a camera.
Yeah. Well, and you know, it's, we could talk to you for quite a while. Fantastic work. Fighting the good fight there, and great stuff. Thank you so much for sharing your photographs with
us
and for joining us on
You're welcome. Thank you for the time.